Listen, you did an amazing thing marrying Brenda, okay? And I'm completely grateful because now Sonny doesn't have to worry about taking care of her. But the woman's insane, okay? She's a nightmare, she hates her guts, and she's gonna make your life hell.
Don't worry.
Well, of course I'm worried. You hate each other, right? Tell me you didn't consummate this marriage, did you?
Why are you giving him a third degree? I mean,
I'm sorry. I'm just concerned about him. That's
you
all.
Maybe need to get a hobby. You have way too much free time.
As district attorney, my priority is to put away criminals like Alcazar, criminals who have bent the law, who have not been caught for some time because they spend hundreds of thousands of dollars on attorneys that will bend the law for them. Well, I have a message to all those attorneys and all those criminals out there, including Alexis Davis, who has made millions of dollars representing Sonny Corinthos. My message is, the party's over.
Ms. Davis, your spot?
Ah, Mr. Corinthos, you come to see me indicted? Your faith in the criminal justice system is surprising. Not to mention a bit naive. Not right, Brenda.
Excuse me just a second. Just a second.
Same site or not? You're still nothing but an opportunist.
My job is to prosecute criminals. If the public likes the way I do it and they want to make me the district attorney, so be it.
Can you get an indictment against Alcazar?
Well, I've got several compelling witnesses against him, including you. Alcazar is not going to walk. Trust me.
You better be right.
I don't know that he can prove Alcazar was behind Christina's death, but at the very least, he can get an indictment against him for shooting Jax. Alexis, you're on the witness list, aren't you? That's correct, Carl. So that means you're going to be on the stand, and you're going to be under oath, which means you'll have to tell the truth for a change, and admit that Sonny had nothing to do with your sister's death, and that everything you said at Christina's funeral was vicious and wrong.
What I said about Roy DeLuca was wrong, and for that I apologize. Everything else I said was perfectly justified. My sister died in Sonny's warehouse because of some vendetta between Alcazar and Sonny, so as far as I'm concerned, the two of them are fully responsible for my sister's death.
You know, you can't even tell the truth to yourself, let alone a grand jury. You know, Christina would never have been anywhere near that warehouse if you had just told Sonny that you might be carrying his child. You know, Christina's death is on your head. So if you're looking for someone to blame, look in the mirror. Excuse me, Sonny. Have you heard from Ryan?
Not directly. My accountant, Benny, spoke with
him. How is he?
As far as I can tell, he's doing well. It looks like Miami agrees with him.
Scott wanted him to come back here to testify today.
Yeah, well, Mr. Baldwin is smart having you testify because you're sympathetic and you didn't shoot anybody.
See you at dinner.
Better to stick to rehab this morning. I'm afraid you'll find this unfulfilling.
I wouldn't miss this for the world.
You risked everything, and you lost.
All rise. This hearing is now in session.
This hearing has been convened to examine the evidence concerning the alleged offenses and misconduct of Luis Alcazar, whether criminal or otherwise, and to take action with respect to such evidence. Mr. Baldwin, you may begin.
I'd call Monica Quartermain to the stand.
I was taken to a cabin where I found Mr. Alcazar suffering from a gunshot wound.
Was Mr. Alcazar conscious?
Yes, he was.
Did he say anything to you?
Yes, he said he wanted to have the bullet removed, and if I let him die, he would have one of his henchmen kill me.
He held me in his apartment at gunpoint.
Mr. Alcazar joined you there?
He did.
Did he give you any reasons why he abducted you?
He was using me as leverage to force Roy DeLuca to murder Sonny Corinthos.
So he admitted to you that he conspired to commit murder?
Yes. In fact, his exact words were, "I'm going to a lot of trouble and expense to have Sonny killed."
The plastique was manufactured in the former Soviet Union. The detonator and the remote trigger were German-made.
Who would have access to weapons like this?
An arms dealer.
Like Mr. Alcazar?
Yes, sir.
If Mr. Alcazar set the bomb, did he intend to kill Christina Cassadine?
The explosion was triggered with a remote detonator with a limited range, probably no farther than the street. Whoever triggered the explosion not only saw Christina Cassadine enter the warehouse, he knew she was going to die.
My sister went to Sonny's warehouse looking for him. She was alone in the warehouse when the bomb that Mr. Alcazar planted went off. I confronted Mr. Alcazar in the hospital and I told him that he murdered my sister.
He wanted to know everything I told his girlfriend about Jasper Jackson, Sonny Corinthos.
Did Mr. Alcazar refer to his girlfriend by name? Is she here in the courtroom?
Yes. Yes, she is. That's her, Brenda Barrett.
Did he say anything else to you?
Yes, he said he wanted to kill me.
Why is that?
He didn't want me to tell anybody about Brenda.
And I told him that Luis had tried to shoot him at the church during his wedding, and I warned him he was going to try again. And I told him he should take his wife and they should leave the country. But they didn't.
Why?
Well, I suppose he thought they were safe here. I was getting ready to leave town myself when Luis showed up.
Was Mr. Alcazar armed?
Yes, he was.
Was Mr. Jax armed?
No, he wasn't. Luis was less than 5 feet away when he shot Jax in the stomach. And then he told me he was going to let him bleed to death.
Is there a possibility Mr. Alcazar was acting out of self-defense?
Well, how would that be if Luis had a gun and Jax didn't? He shot Jax in the stomach. He didn't care afterwards. If you look at him now, he doesn't care now. He is a murderer. And I hope somebody murders him.
The state seeks to indict Luis Alcazar on the following charges. One count of murder in the first degree in the death of Christina Cassadine. Three counts of attempted murder. Five separate accounts of kidnapping. The government also charges solicitation, conspiracy, and lesser included offenses, all of which are included in the state's brief.
Mr. Bowman, there's a government official who needs to see you immediately.
What, are you crazy?
Yeah, he's outside in the hall.
Get out of here. I'm busy.
He's got more credentials than I got campaign buttons.
I'm in the middle of a hearing here.
A problem, Mr. Baldwin?
Your Honor, something requires my immediate attention. I beg the court for a couple of minutes.
You have 90 seconds, Mr. Baldwin.
Thank you.
He's right here, mister. Well, this better be important.
It's pivotal to your case.
What is this?
Looks like Alcazar called him a favor. Do you know what this is?
No, I don't. What is it? Is he gonna rob?
I sincerely hope, Mr. Baldwin, you have a good reason for interrupting these proceedings.
Your Honor, the state moves to drop all charges against Alcazar.
Order, order. Order in the court. Order. If you don't show just cause for this outrageous reversal, you'll be held personally liable for all costs attendant to these proceedings. And your office will be looking at a contempt charge for malicious abuse of process. Do you hear me?
Your Honor, may I approach the bench?
Yes, you may. Under the circumstances, my hands are tied. I'm compelled to dismiss all charges against Luis Alcazar. Marshal, the prisoner's release. Luis Alcazar, you're a free man.
Wait a minute. What?
Issue. I'm not at liberty to discuss right now, so we're just going to have to leave it at that. Okay?
Someone made you a deal and you took it.
My hands are tied.
He murdered my sister. He shot Jax. He needs to be punished. That's the law. That's your job, to see that justice is served. Where's my sister's justice? Where's the punishment for taking her life?
Give my regards to your friend at the state.
Miss Davis is obviously upset here. She lost her sister, but the law will not be used as an instrument for revenge. She has suffered quite a loss, as well as other people. I personally wish that it was something I could do, but however, my hands are tied at this moment. So, that's all.
Excuse me. As district attorney, I'm directing this request to you. I want a police escort out of here.
You out of your mind.
This was just left for me in the courtroom.
I guess I have an obligation to give you a police escort. It appears that someone here has threatened Mr. Alcazar's life.
The the gun.
You just not get him.
Trick or treat.
I guess we're interrupting.
Look at your costume. I love it. What made you decide to be a firefighter?
People like firemen, so they'll get more candy.
You're just like your dad. You know what? We don't have any candy.
Actually,
right now.
We do have candy.
Look at that.
This is the stuff you said was best, right?
Right.
Okay, so, well, how many do you want?
Two. You'll have two.
Carly, I have a whole bag right here.
Yeah, and he's got a whole building to go trick-or-treating in. It's no fun if your family gives you all your candy before you get started, right?
All right, so grab two, and then you can come back tomorrow because I have this whole bag left over for you, all right?
Cool.
You want to show Brenda and Jason what we got for them?
Oh, yeah, come on!
Come on. We didn't think that you'd have a pumpkin, so...
It's a jack-o'-lantern.
Oh, right. What's their car? Sorry, they're jack-o'-lanterns.
Wow, look at that. That's great.
Yeah, that's cool, man. Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, they were carving them at the pumpkin patch, right?
Now kids will know you have candy to give out if their moms will let them out of the elevator to go trick-or-treating. Sometimes they won't because moms are afraid of daddy's guards.
Well, you know what the answer to that is. The guards will have the night off for Halloween. Right, Sonny? Jason's here, you know, in case anything happens.
Please, Daddy.
Are you sure? Pick up your hat. All right, it's a special occasion.
Yay.
Marco can stay in the lobby. Come here, Marco.
Isn't it fair for the next couple of hours? Stay downstairs until, you know, the children thin out, will you? Thanks.
Oh, hey, hold that elevator, will you? Because we're going to ride with you, because it's time to,
Trick or treat.
All right.
All
right.
Thank you, guys. Oh, your hair keeps falling off. Grab it.
I was going to go out, but since you had...
Now you know, there's still time we can come up with a costume for you.
No. You know what?
What?
I don't do mud, I don't cook desserts, and I don't wear costumes. But you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to escort you to this charity benefit, and I'm going to watch you and everybody else make fools of themselves.
You know, I am so glad that Michael is asleep, and he can't hear his father being negative about Halloween.
Well,
brat.
The point I'm making is, you know, Halloween, like dressing up and that stuff, it's for children, not for grown men and women. But I gotta tell you, you look damn good in that outfit.
Yeah.
You don't believe me? Just ask the man who's got everything. If you want to hang on to the person you love with all your heart, you will do whatever it takes. You will fight with everything you've got. And don't worry about playing fair.
Would you make a deal with the devil to keep Courtney?
In a heartbeat.
Well, let me guess. Gangster, right?
Instead of being half naked, why don't you do your job for once and put a case together against Alcazar that will stick?
Man, it's funny you mention that because that's why I came over to warn you that Alcazar is the PCPD's problem to solve, right? So if he should happen to have a fatal accident, he's the first person I'm going to arrest, right?
Like always?
Oh, honey, you look great.
No, you do.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
Did you wear that trick-or-treating with Michael?
Oh, I sure did.
Oh, well, good for you. Did you get pictures of him and his little fireman outfit?
Oh, I got half a roll, and I will get you copies as soon as it's all developed.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I did notice, though, you couldn't get Sonny into a costume.
Oh, it took everything I had to just get him out of the house. I had to tell him we had to be here because we had to support the hospital.
So, how are things with Brenda living across the hall? Any idea how the marriage with Jason is going?
Marriage. Jason sacrificed himself so Sonny wouldn't feel obligated to take care of Brenda.
Let's get a drink.
Let's.
Whoever you are, I'm guessing you're my mom.
Daughter's an excellent dancer. Where to be next?
You stay away from my daughters. I will protect them at any cost. Come on, let's go.
Me, Sonny. Were you as surprised as we were at Brenda and Jason's elopement?
I didn't see it coming.
Because we all love Brenda. But she is suffering from a terminal mental illness, and Jason has taken it upon himself to nurse her through this.
That was his decision.
Or was it yours, Sonny? You can't take care of Brenda because you're married to Carly. So did you tell Jason that he had to go through hell watching Brenda die just because you can't?
Monica, excuse me, okay?
No, I mean it, Sonny.
My wife. You come near my family again, I'll kill you. Where's Alcazar?
I don't know any Alcazar.
Don't lie to me.
I swear. Look, I just came to the party.
Yeah, dressed in the exact same outfit.
It's a coincidence.
You're lying to me. You are lying to me. Get out of here.
Wait, let's just have a drink, okay?
He works for Alcazar.
Okay, either that or he's completely innocent and he had nothing to say. You know what? Either way, he wasn't going to say anything.
Alcazar switched places to buy time, okay? He's headed for Brenda. Says she's okay? But what? Okay, you know what? Just don't leave the penthouse floor at all. Thanks.
Brenda's all right?
Well, that's what she told Monica.
And you're not sure?
Well, look, Alcazar went to a lot of trouble to arrange the switch, and, you know, he'd only do that for Brenda.
Then you should go to her. Really, Sonny, I'm not going to keep you from taking care of her.
Marco says Jason's not there, Brenda's alone. I just like to, you know...
It's okay, it's okay. You know what? You go, you do what you need to do.
I know what it took for you to say that.
No, you don't.
I need to check myself, you know.
Yeah, you know what? Go. Take care of what you need to take care of. Because I don't want you at home in our bed with Brenda on your mind.
All right, this is about safety. You know that. That's all it's about.
It's okay. It's okay.
I'll see you then. Okay.
Okay. Be safe. He is off protecting Brenda from Alcazar.
Well, it is understandable.
Excuse me?
What man is a killer? Look what he did to Jack.
Okay, you know what? I really doubt that there's any worry that Brenda's going to get shot by Alcazar tonight. But of course, naturally, my husband has to run off and take care of her in her own home, by the way.
Alcazar is a manipulator. He charmed Maxie into dancing with him earlier. And then, when Felicia came up, he took off his mask and he revealed who he was. And both Felicia and Maxie were terrified, which of course is exactly what he wanted.
Why doesn't that man just disappear?
Well, I'm sure he will eventually. They'll catch him.
Well, maybe I did the right thing then by sending Sonny off to Brenda.
You told Sonny to go.
Don't act so surprised, yes.
Well, it's just so grown up.
Well, what else am I supposed to do?
You know what? I would like to rip every single hair out of her head, but...
But the woman's dying,
and Sonny feels responsible for her welfare.
And I hate it. But I don't know how to fight her.
Oh, honey, just be honest. And no stunts and no crazy schemes. Just be honest with him and show him that he can trust you. And every day he'll know that he chose the right woman.
And what if he decides that he didn't?
Hello? You're at the police station right now? Oh, my goodness.
Thank you, Audrey.
Well, Lucky is in trouble. He's at the police station. That was Audrey, so, I gotta go.
Oh, just,
well, don't forget. Be honest.
Yeah.
Be honest.
Okay, okay. Honey. Okay,
So, has Sonny left you for Brenda yet?
Believe anything that you say.
This is what you asked me to do, Brenda, right from the beginning. Do you want it or not?
Take him out. Kill him.
I hate to disappoint you, Edward, but Sonny and I have never been happier.
Oh. What a marvelously brave front. You know, I should think that your heart would be breaking after what I just heard.
Edward, don't stop.
No. Hey, I just wanted to offer you my sympathies, that's all.
Oh, really? And also tell me that if Sonny and I, we break up, that Michael always has a home.
No, you see, I just wanted to ensure the welfare of little Michael's mother.
Oh, it's very thoughtful of you.
And just know that our door is always open to Michael.
Could you... For one moment, show a little support for Brenda and Jason, seeing that the ink isn't even dry on the marriage certificate.
Are you undermining Jason's marriage already?
God, you don't actually think that they married for love, do you?
Give them a chance, Edward.
God, don't be naive. The only reason that Brenda married Jason was so she could be closer to Sonny.
I certainly understand you thinking like that.
Hey, it's working, isn't it?
No, it's not.
All right, then. Where is your husband right now? Some important business meeting?
Don't kill anyone for me.
He's not getting another chance to hurt you.
Wow. You know, I always knew, but I've never heard you actually say those words out loud.
Well, I've warned them to stay away.
Well, I don't want any more violence, so you either call the police or you let him go.
Max, escort Mr. Alcazar outside.
It appears the lady doesn't want to be rescued.
Get him out of here.
You're lying to Brenda.
Right.
And to your wife.
Why isn't Jason looking out for you?
I'm taking care of myself, and don't you ever barge in here and order someone to be killed in front of me.
Have you forgotten who this man is?
As soon as I heard that Luke's been
in your business.
Sonny is with Brenda, and Jason is nowhere to be found.
Will you stop stirring up trouble?
You don't believe Brenda's gloriously romantic story of their wedding, do you?
Well, maybe she was exaggerating.
Oh, God, it's a blatant pack of lies.
You know, a lot of the marriages in this family started out for the wrong reason, Edward. Maybe Jason and Brenda married for convenience sake, but who knows where it's going to lead?
Monica's right. Maybe if Jason is happy, he'll come back to the family.
Oh, yes, and pigs might fly.
God, you're such a pessimist.
And you live in a fool's paradise. But you know something, Carly? I'd have thought you'd seen through this from the very beginning.
Okay, you know what? What? Brenda is Sonny's past. He's over her.
You were desperate to escape, Alcazar. You never wanted to see him again.
He came to the door. He wanted to talk to me. I tried to shut the door.
And that turned you around? A little moment of sincerity?
Don't worry about it. You're not in charge of me.
You know what
anymore.
He did?
Yes,
he walked into that party. He planted a decoy so nobody would see that he would get out.
Why do you think he did that? That was the only way he could talk to me without having his life threatened.
You've been through hell and back with this guy. Why are you defending him?
But are you crazy? I'm not defending him. I'm sorry, Sonny. I don't want people killing each other.
The law cannot touch him. So he's out doing what he does best, playing with people's minds. That includes you.
Yeah, right. Okay, thank you for your brilliant analysis.
He's using you. Your illness, everything you guys had, is making you forget he's a killer.
I'll never forget he's a killer.
or a liar, or a criminal. But you can't imagine how I could be with somebody like that.
It's not the same.
Yeah, you're right, it's not the same. At least he's pretending like he's trying to help me.
How? What is he trying to get you to do?
I've been waiting for you. I got good news. I'm getting Brenda out of town. Sonny will never have to see her again. All I need from you is to give Brenda a little push in the right direction.
What kind of game is Alcazar running on you?
Don't worry about it. If you're not in charge of the time I have left, you should just go.
Is that why you're listening to this man? Because you think you're dying?
I don't know.
So you're just going to give up? Go away with a killer because you think your life means nothing?
My life does mean nothing, and I have to remember that. So.
What would you want if you weren't dying?
I don't want to play make-believe.
You never think about what you do if you're gonna live?
No, I don't. I mean, what's the point of doing that? I'm dying, so what?
No. You're already dead.
You ordered my husband's murder. Why should I believe a word you say?
Because I'm a magician.
You know what? You're taking this Halloween thing a bit far, don't you think?
I can make Brenda disappear.
Well, you haven't so far.
All I need is a clever assistant.
Oh, then that would be me.
That's right. Now you see Brenda, now you don't. Who else can give you that? Jason? Your husband?
Just tell me what you want.
I'm dying. Jason's dying, even out of
prison. Oh, God, you're so philosophical these days.
Life is a game with one rule. Nobody gets out alive.
Especially if they're around you.
You ever think about what you could have done in the past 4 years? I mean, you know, you gave up. You hung out with Alexander on that yacht. 4 years, that's a college degree. Start to a good marriage. You could have set the world on fire.
And I still can.
That's the Brenda I know.
You don't know me.
Then who does? Alcazar? Jax?
Jax knows me on a deeper level than he'll ever understand. Yeah.
How deep is that?
Get out.
What?
No, don't tell me what I need. Get out.
I'm going.
Good.
Take it easy.
Leave. Go home and tell your wife what to do.
I'm going
to
do that, okay?
Yeah, well, great. I don't really care. I've cared for a long time.
I'm leaving.
You know, and if I did have a future, just so you know, I wouldn't spend 2 seconds of it with you.
You've been great to talk to.
Yeah, thank you. I'd go rescue Jax from that lying idiot that he married.
Private jet is waiting. The flight plan has been filed. I'm taking Brenda to Paris. You'll never have to see her again.
Just tell me what you want.
All you have to do is get Brenda on that plane.
I wasn't dragging her by her hair.
It's not quite that simple.
Oh, don't be so sure.
Brenda has to want to go. Now, logic is telling her to go now, tonight.
Yeah, well, that works for me.
Brenda's heart rules. And her heart is telling her to stay here with Jax. Or with your husband. That's why I need your help.
You know, Brenda and I aren't exactly close.
Doesn't matter.
Why is she gonna listen to me?
Because you're both in love with Sonny. That gives you and Brenda a connection.
Do you have any idea how bizarre this sounds?
It's in your best interest to have her go with me.
Oh, well, what do you want me to do? You want me to mess with her mind?
You know what she wants? Use that. If kindness works, be kind. If it doesn't, be brutal. Make Brenda never want to see poor Charles again.
Yeah, well, I could do that.
And if you have to, remind her that she's sick and she's running out of time. Tell her there's nothing here for her and poor Charles.
You know, I can't promise you anything.
Your husband just left you to be with Brenda. You want to spend the rest of your life like that, abandoned on your own? I'm sure Sonny loves you. But he will always choose Brenda. Can't help himself. And you can't change that. But you can make Brenda disappear with my help. You have a problem with that?
No. No problem.
How was the party?
You know, I decided to change my costume because I got bored with it. I decided to change into leather pants, shave my head.
What?
Nothing. Did you find Brenda?
Yeah.
Was she in trouble?
She's been in trouble ever since she woke up on that yacht. Alcazar's been playing with her mind for 4 years, and he's at it again.
Did you stop him?
For tonight. There you go.
Thank you.
How was the party, really?
Well, Alan and Monica think that Jason and Brenda are passionately in love and that she's going to lure him back into the family. Where the hell is he anyway?
That's a good question.
Yeah, well, so much for him looking out for Brenda.
I'll speak with Jason.
Sonny, it's not going to matter.
What do you mean?
Really, it won't, because you know what? Brenda's always going to need you, no matter what, and Edward thinks you're already sleeping with her.
That... He told you that?
Yeah,
at the
he did. I ignored him.
I should have never left you there.
You know
I'm sorry.
It's okay. It's fine.
Mm.
Sonny, do you think that if two women have loved the same man and love him, do you think they're connected somehow? Like, one woman can control the other.
Where is this coming from?
Alcazar.
What do you mean? You spoke
he
to Alcazar?
He was waiting for me outside the club tonight.
He was waiting outside? He set me up? What did he do?
It's okay. I'm okay.
No,
I'm
just
fine.
Well, how come you didn't call me?
Because you know what?
Matt?
It wasn't
was
a big
Matt?
Deal. I came.
No, it is a big deal because now Alcazar knows he can get to my wife by using Brenda. That's what this was about tonight. Tell me. I want to know exact words. What did he say?
Alcazar wants me to manipulate Brenda so he can take her away.
Alcazar used Brenda to draw me away. Anything could have happened. I should not have left you there. That was my fault.
Okay, you know what? And then you would have worried about Brenda all night, and we would be a lot worse off than
he should
right
leave
now.
My wife out of this.
Okay,
that's
Sonny,
it's
Sonny,
not you.
Every single fiber of my being was telling me to lie to you tonight, okay? I didn't want to tell you about Alcazar. I wanted to just get Brenda out of town. Sweetie, when I lie to you, it leads me so far away from you, and I don't want to be there. I want to be with you. I want to be with you so much more than I want Brenda gone.
You did good. Okay.
Came to my club, okay? And Brenda and I just had a huge fight, and it was in front of Jack, so I really wasn't in the best frame of mind about her, okay? And Alcazar said he just wanted to see her, to talk to her, so...
You set her up!
No! I never meant for her to be kidnapped!
Okay, Jason,
did you see Alcazar
as
take
you
Brenda?
Get this, I'm serious.
Well, I was in the back room, but she came to
how many
club.
Men?
Two plus Alcazar.
Did you see him leave with these men?
Yes!
Did you hear him say anything?
No.
Like...
I know. Well, you know what? He might be taking her to Paris.
Okay, Alcazar, when he stopped me on Halloween, he said that he had a private jet waiting to take her to Paris.
I never meant for her to be hurt.
Careful.
careful, okay? Please. All right, you know what? You can drop your phony little act because I know exactly what you were up to.
You were trying to hold on to your husband by throwing my husband at Brenda.
I came looking for Jason. I wasn't knocking on your door.
No, but you had to come in person instead of just calling, which you could have done. So you come over here, you scream at the top of your lungs so the whole building can hear, especially Sonny. Because that way, you can keep your husband. Because the best way to keep Jax is to shove Brenda into my husband's arms.
Well, you seem absolutely convinced of that, so why argue?
You know what? Sonny will do everything to make sure Brenda is safe, but it stops right there. So you can stop shoving her in his way because it's not going
to
work.
All I want is for her to be okay.
Well, then you're an idiot, okay? Because you know what? You should be hoping and praying that Alcazar gets her on that plane and far away because you're going to lose Jax otherwise.
Don't. Obviously, that's what you're hoping, Carly.
What if it's the other way around? What if you're about to lose Sonny?
Hey, did Luis's episode jet leave you?
I don't know. You're going to have to check with Tom.
You know what, man?
Hey, this is a restricted area.
Yeah,
right. I wanted me to work Brenda, too, but I refused.
Oh, yeah? Give Brenda a few hours alone with your husband. You might reconsider.
What woman with half her brain would give that little twit a minute with her husband?
Hey! Jax was shot, okay? And after the surgery, the doctors thought that he was going to be paralyzed. He didn't want me tied to a man in a wheelchair, so he pushed me away.
And you let him?
My mind was reeling, okay? I wasn't thinking straight. My God, my husband had just been shot after our wedding, trying to protect his former love, who was supposedly dead.
Yeah, well, you know what, sweetie? If you were too shaken up to fight for your own husband, it's your problem, not mine.
Look, Jax has convinced me that he is over Brenda, okay? And that he loves me, and that our marriage is safe. I was just trying to give him the benefit of the doubt.
Well, you should have reserved him a hotel room then, okay? Because you're not about to lose Jax. You already lost him the minute that he found out that Brenda was alive.
Oh, God. You sound just like Brenda. She told me she actually thinks she can get my husband back.
See, it was goading you to see if you would overreact, and obviously it worked. Okay, you know what? You don't have to worry so much because she's not going to hang on to Jax for long because she's dying.
Yeah, notice how Brenda only seems to be dying when she needs a little sympathy.
Well, you know, she already tried the sympathy thing with Sonny. But you know what? I don't care. I don't care if the woman stands around in the rain in a negligee and advertises on a bulletin board that she is dying because she's not going to get Sonny, because he is committed to me.
You hope? What if some old feelings are resurfaced when and if Sonny rescues Brenda? Knowing how much you'll hate, that makes it worth having to tell Jax the truth.
Well, why start now?
Preemptive damage control. Jax is going to have to find out the truth anyway. Once Sonny gets back with Brenda.
Oh my God, what are you doing here?
I got passed out.
Get me out of these. Get me out of these.
You're going to hurt yourself. Don't do
this. Just get me out of these, please.
Who's it? Alcazar's flying the plane?
Yes, yes.
Anybody with him?
No, I don't think so. He likes to fly by himself.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. It's just, I don't know what we're going to do now because he's the only one who knows how to land the plane. You don't know how to fly a plane, right?
Okay, he's got to land this thing sooner or later, and I'll be ready for him, but I need a weapon.
You don't have your gun with you?
I couldn't get it past security.
Okay, go in the galley, in the kitchen. There's knives.
Not exactly a textbook takeoff, but somehow fitting for leaving poor Charles. Looks like we're back where we started, Brenda. Just the two of us.
He's taking us to Paris.
He's not taking you to Paris.
How do you know that?
Too big of a chance of getting caught. He's going to go someplace where we can bribe the police.
Oh, God. Thank you.
We are on autopilot, kids. Did you leave me to land? What's your know-how?
I never got around to attending flight school.
Oh, that's too bad.
Yeah.
You know, you should have stayed in Port Charles instead of running after Brenda. Because now you give me a second chance to kill you.
Well, you're going to have to land the plane first. Because if you come at me right now, we're going to fight. And I may kill you. And then we're all going to die. Who's going to fly the plane, right? You got to land it first, Alcazar. How long after that do you think I can be on you?
You know, I'm confident I can protect myself.
Well, you think you can fly the plane at the same time? I don't think you're that good, Alcazar.
I've survived this long, haven't I? You know, I've walked away from a hell of a lot worse than a small time away from Bensonhurst.
That's before you were afraid to lose. You're scared now. Brenda's slipping away. You may never get her back.
I already got her.
Hmm?
I'll kill myself first.
You won't get the chance. I'm taking you somewhere safe.
Brenda, get that belt on. Crinthos don't bother. You won't last 10 minutes after we land.
Good, right?
Okay, listen. At the airport?
Yeah.
There was a couple guys at the airport that looked like they were going to fuel the plane. I think Alcazar didn't put enough fuel in this
plane. Brenda, check to see if your seatbelt's tight. We're making an emergency landing.
Okay. Thank God. Where have you been? I have been leaving you messages everywhere.
I was following up on something for Courtney. What's wrong?
Brenda's gone. Alcazar kidnapped
What?
Her. Yeah.
When? What
she
happened?
She showed up at Club 101 to meet Sky, right? And Alcazar showed up, grabbed her. He's probably on a plane with her right now going to Paris.
Does Sonny know?
Yes, he knows. He took off after her as soon as he heard about it, okay? And that was ages ago. I haven't heard from him since. I called the airport. Jeez. Alcazar's plane already took off. You know what this means? You know, he went to help Brenda, and now Alcazar's got both of them.
Look, let's not assume the worst yet.
Well, what do
okay?
you assume? Huh? That they decided to go on vacation together?
I'm not worried
together?
About Sonny. He can handle Alcazar.
Yeah, I know that. Okay, and I can just imagine how grateful Brenda's going to be. She's going to throw herself into his arms, thank him so much, and the next thing you know, he's gone.
Good. Just have the jet fueled and tell Manny I'm leaving tonight.
All right, we have the ID number of Alcazar's plane, N71SG. There's no pilot aboard. Alcazar is flying the plane himself. He filed a partial flight plan. They're headed to Venezuela.
Venezuela? What happened to Paris?
It doesn't matter. This is better. Sonny has contacts in South America. I'll arrange for them to have people in place at every airport. We might be able to intercept them.
Okay, what happens if something goes wrong?
Well, that's why I'm going. Sonny's going to need backup.
Okay, so am I.
No, forget it.
No, I swear I'll
Carly,
do what
you
say.
Carly, you stand here.
No, but
there's,
I can help
There's nothing you,
you
can do, Carly.
Yes, I can fight for Sonny. Jason, you know as well as I do that this whole situation is just pushing Sonny into Brenda's
Look,
arms.
You know how I feel about Brenda, but you can't blame her because she got kidnapped.
Oh, the
by
hell
Alcazar.
I can't, okay? She decided to open the door to Alcazar and let him in. She's also married to you who can protect her. And what does she do? She ditches you the moment she has a chance, and she goes off on her own. You know, she's practically wearing a sign around her neck that says, Alcazar, come take me, but make sure that Sonny knows about
There's
it.
There's no way Brenda did this on purpose, okay? It's impossible.
Of course she didn't. Okay, this is Brenda's gift. All right, she sits around and she waits and lets things happen to her, and then she waits for her savior of the moment to come and save her. Usually it's Jax or Sonny, and then when that happens, she throws her arms around them, promises to love them completely until the
Carly,
next time.
Carly, you're right about Brenda, okay? But that does not change the fact that Sonny is in danger right now, and so is she.
Yeah, okay, all I am asking you to do is let me help you. You're the one who told me to fight for Sonny, so I want to know, have you changed your mind? Jason, I will do whatever you tell me to do. I will stay out of the way. Look, I just need to be close to Sonny or Brenda's going to move in.
Don't you have any faith in Sonny at all?
I know Sonny, and so do you. He's going to hate himself for giving in to Brenda, and I just need to be there to stop him so he won't have the chance.
Sonny,
do you see what an understanding wife I am being?
He married you, Carly.
Yes, he did, and you know what? Remember when he married me the first time? You bet me $20 that I'd be happy. So if he leaves me for Brenda, you're gonna lose the bet. You don't want to do that. Do you? You don't.
I'll call you from Venezuela or something.
Jason, please.
Carly. You don't have anything to worry about. Sonny's coming back to you. Nice.
Carly.
Hey,
it's nice
hey,
work.
Okay,
you had to move
say,
pretty fast
see,
to get to the airport before
well,
me.
Well, you know what? I was motivated.
Sit down. You think this is a joke? You could have been hurt. Why don't you ever listen?
Yeah. Because I don't have a choice. Because you don't listen to reason. And you obviously don't care that I am fighting for everything that I believe in and to save everything I have. And you're taking sides with Sonny.
Wait, what are you talking? There are no sides. You and Sonny are married.
Yeah, and you knew that Brenda was alive as soon as Sonny did, and you knew they were staying in the safe house together.
That's right. Brenda thought Sonny was dead.
And it didn't keep Sonny from staying in the next room pining for her. Jason, look me in the eye. Look me in the eye and tell me that's not exactly what happened.
Sonny was in the safe house because that's where he's supposed to hide. And Brenda was there because we didn't have any place to put her. Nothing happened, Carly.
Really? Okay, then why didn't Sonny tell me that Brenda was alive? You wanted to tell me, didn't you? You did. I know you, and Sonny wouldn't let you, so you lied. You kept his secret, and you didn't tell me the truth, okay? You know what? You sided with him.
You're lucky that he even let you in on this plane in the first place, okay? And by the way, Sonny wanted Brenda to go back to Europe before she knew he was even alive.
Oh, well, you know what? It didn't work out that way, did it? No, so she's been jerking him around ever since. Just tell me something. Tell me, if I lose Sonny to Brenda, how are you gonna feel then? You gonna like that? Is it what you want?
Carly, why? Why do you do this? Why do you make things up in your mind and act like they've already happened when they haven't?
Sonny is with Brenda right now.
So what? You're Sonny's wife. He's not going to bail on you for Brenda or anybody else unless you flip out and you do something crazy to drive him away.
Right, give him an excuse to leave our marriage?
Since when did you decide being married to you was something Sonny wants to get out of? Because from what I've seen, he's doing everything he can to keep your family together.
Jason, I want to believe that. Okay, I really do, but I'm telling you, if he stays with me out of some sense of duty, I'm gonna hate that. And then I am gonna do something crazy. Look, I feel like he still loves Brenda. It's true, isn't it?
Yeah, you're right.
So is this your way of telling me I just wasted a trip?
What do you want me to tell you, Carly? That Sonny loved Brenda? That he lost his mind for Brenda? He almost died for her. At one point, he pretty much gave up everything because of Brenda?
Trying to reassure me now?
But you keep at it. You keep asking me. He can't make it work with Brenda. And he knows that. She's like poison to him. She messes with his mind, she ruined his life, and he's just as bad for her. Look, there are some people that you love that you can't be with for whatever reason.
Like you and me. We tried to be together and couldn't make it work. That's what you're talking about, huh?
Yeah, that's... Look, not only do you and Sonny love each other, okay, your relationship works. I don't know how, but you worked good together. You've proved it over and over. Just trust that.
Jason, I am trying. I swear I am. But I have this feeling. I have this feeling that something is going to go wrong. And I'm going to lose Sonny and everything we have.
Morgan.
Did you find anything out?
Senor Alcazar is a difficult man to track.
His plane was headed here.
He never landed. The plane went off radar somewhere over the Caribbean.
Is he saying that they crashed?
Bizarre has a landing strip we don't know about.
There's always a chance, but it's a jet. Most private airstrips can't accommodate it.
I don't know.
Do you have an approximate location where the plane might have dropped off the radar?
Near Tortura, but there are no landing strips in the area.
Crash.
No, it means we have a place to start looking. All right, we're going to head back to the airport. Thanks.
Está arrestado. Ponga sus manos arriba.
Brenda. Hey. Hey.
Wake up, okay? Wake up.
Bit of the survival crap, you know that. Hey. You gotta help me out here, okay? Open your eyes, will you? You're not gonna die on me. Okay. I know you're gonna wake up. Because I'm gonna admit to you something about myself that you never knew. And then you're gonna open your eyes. Mad and claiming you knew all along because that's the way you are. Remember that diamond bracelet I sent you? I sent it to the quartermans and you called me back, said thank you, but you can't keep it. You said you'd meet me at the Outback. Remember that? Huh? This whole speech about how much it meant to you, but you know, this and that. And my date walked in, some hot blonde. And you got all mad and possessive. And you accused me of setting it up, huh? I told you I didn't. I lied. I set it up. I wanted to see if you would fight for me. Hey, come on, get up. You gotta wake up. Hey.
Yeah.
Sorry. You all right? It's me.
Sonny.
Yeah.
Did I hit my head? Cause it.
Yeah, you've been unconscious for hours.
Oh God, it hurts so much.
Yeah. You feeling good, huh?
Yeah.
All right. Okay.
What? Oh my God! Did the plane crash?
Yeah, Alcazar landed it wherever he could. You were strapped in. I carried you as far as I could, okay? I've got this. First aid kit.
Oh, she's fine.
Oh, yeah, give me.
Whoa. Take one of these. Okay?
Give me.
You got it?
Yeah. Oh. Is somebody coming? Is the Coast Guard coming?
We're in it. Okay, listen. We're in the Caribbean, all right? There's small islands all over the place. Unless Alcazar told somebody...
Where's Luis? Is he dead?
Hey, you know what? You can't do this. We are American citizens.
Just take it easy.
You know why? We didn't do anything wrong. It's not like you had a gun or anything.
Carla,
it's not like...
That's enough, okay? We're not going to get anywhere by guessing. Señor, ¿por qué estamos aquí? No hemos hecho nada mal.
Escogiste un mal lugar para enseñar tu cara. Ustedes son enemigos de Alcazar.
What did he say? All I got was Alcazar.
He said we picked the wrong place to show up. We're Alcazar's enemies.
The cockpit window was smashed. The cockpit was intact. Alcazar was nowhere to be found.
That means he survived, so he's out here somewhere.
Yeah, he may be hurt, maybe right. Hiding, I don't know, but you know what? We gotta concentrate on getting ourselves out of here, okay?
Ow.
So stay right.
All right.
You're all right.
You don't have a cell phone?
No.
Did you already check the radio on the plane?
It's dead.
All right, well, we have to leave a signal. We have to write a message in the sand. Ow! All right. We have to light a fire, okay?
Okay, we have no matches. All we have is food,
and light the
water,
fire.
And this first aid kit.
Well, you didn't look very good because there's other... Oh, my God.
Hey.
I've never had a headache this bad before. Where's my coat?
Hey.
I need my coat. Find my coat for me right now. Where did it? Wait, did I have a coat?
No, I don't know.
I did have a coat. My medicine's in it, and
coat.
I need it.
Okay, I'm going back to the phone.
No, wait. I'll go because I know the jet better than you do.
Hey, Brenda, listen.
No.
You need to. Can you just sit back, relax? You're gonna faint.
All right, fine. You go into the plane. Go. The only reason why I'm listening to you is because my head hurts so bad that I can't argue with you about it, so just go.
Whatever you say.
Hey, we are American citizens, right? Okay, somebody's got to call the American consulate and let them know that we've been arrested.
That's enough, okay? I wouldn't count on it. This is not a legitimate arrest. Somebody paid those cops to pick us up. No one even knows that we're here.
It's good to know you understand your situation. It saves me the trouble of having to explain it to you.
Excuse me, but there's been some mistake because we haven't done anything wrong.
Explain to the lady there will be no formal charges. No trial. You are here as part of a private arrangement I have with Luis Alcazar.
Look, hey, we can make our own arrangement.
What would you be offering?
I'll pay whatever fine that you decide and any expenses to secure our release right now.
That could be expensive, amigo.
Well, I'm well financed.
Yeah,
we got the money.
Take this. You know what? As a sign of good faith, my husband gave it to me. It's very valuable. It's real. It's from my husband.
It's good to know you understand my position.
So do you think he's going to take the bribe or not, Jason?
Carly, it's...
Try to eat.
I'm not hungry.
Well, food may help.
Thank you.
Well, you know what? Why don't you just take one little bite and see? Because if you're not eating, it's not good for you.
God. If I take a bite of that, will you refrain from speaking for even just a few seconds?
Yeah, I'll try.
Pasta in $1,000 pots.
Yeah.
I better light a fire. Here. I can light one. And now I have amazing survival instincts in case you haven't noticed. I'm like a cat.
What?
Yeah.
You can take care of me?
Yeah, I could take care of you. It's not that hard, you know. I mean, we're in the tropics. There's food everywhere out here.
Oh.
Banana trees right behind you.
How do you know it's a banana tree?
Because they're covered in bananas. You're right there.
Oh, well.
You've got the rough location. Come get Brendan and I off the sandbox. You don't have to worry about Corinthos. You won't be leaving the island alive. When you arrive, I want you to isolate and eliminate Corinthos. I don't want Brenda anywhere.
All right, there's nothing out there. Nothing except for some nasty-looking barbed wire. You know what? No one is going to come and rescue us. That is for sure. Jason, what if the warden doesn't take your offer?
Carly, you shouldn't be here.
No, nor should you, because it's called wrongful imprisonment.
No, I should have turned that jet around the minute I found you and taken you home.
Jason, we both know that I would have been on the first commercial plane out here, and we would have been in the same situation, except I would have been alone. I would have been terrified, so... You know what? It's so much better this way, because we're together at least. And you don't have to come and search for me.
I'm going to get you out of this. I don't know how, but I will.
I know. I know. You know, you've never, no matter how horrible a situation, God let me down. You've always come through. I'm going to come through for you, too, Jason. I intend to, okay? You know what? That warden, He probably decided to take the offer the minute it came out of your mouth. He wants to make us wait.
No, the warden wants to get the money first to make sure Alcazar doesn't find out.
Yeah. What's that? Someone's in that next cell, huh? Hey, guard. Senor?
Senor.
Excuse me, what? What's going on? What is that music?
Canción.
Se llama Los Perdidos. Te la toca a ti. Quiere decir que estás sentenciado a muerte.
What is that? What the hell did he say?
He said the song is called The Lost Ones. And the prisoner's playing it for us.
Why?
Because the warden turned us down, he's gonna have us executed.
Okay, listen. Listen up, listen here, okay? You know, you get no money from us unless we are alive. Warden, listen to me. My husband, he will pay lots of money. He will pay $2 million for our release.
Your husband is a stranger. Luis Alcazar is a powerful friend. And a deadly enemy. So, you have to die.
Hello?
Hello?
Okay, espérate. Estamos perdidos. Está.
Te dije que seguir la pista podría.
Estamos perdidos. Damn it.
What?
Battery went dead.
Well, did you get to tell them enough? I mean, you think they're going to show up here still?
Well, you know, I don't know. I mean, it's a matter of who shows up here first.
Right. At least his guys are coming too.
Well, he probably told his people the exact coordinates and, you know, they got a nice head start.
Are we kidding? Really, listen, if I had to run this dump of a prison, I'd follow Alcazar's orders too.
No, you would take any bribe. And get the hell out of town. You're smart. The warden isn't.
Yeah, well, it doesn't take much intelligence to line two people up against a wall and shoot them.
Hey, we are not getting shot.
Oh, my God, what about Michael? Jason, what is Michael going to do without his mom and his daddy and his uncle Jason?
Carly, stop it. Hey. Do not lose it, okay? You need to pay attention to me.
Okay.
Are you listening?
Yeah.
Okay, look at me. Have I ever broken a promise to you?
Never.
Okay, then. I promise you I will get you out of here, but you have to promise me something, too.
Okay?
That when I distract the guards...
Distract them
now. Don't worry about that. Do not talk. Just listen to me. Okay?
Okay.
Just seconds. The guards focus on me. You need to run. Like hell, you do not look back. You get to that nursery,
Jason,
you tell Maddie
to take off. Stop it! Because I'm not letting you do this. I'm not going to let you sacrifice your life.
Listen to me. If anyone should run, it should be you. You're much faster than I am. I'll distract the guards,
okay? If I run, what's going to happen to you? You're going to get shot for causing trouble. Is that what you want? Isn't the goal to get home to Michael?
Yes, and I want us both to get home.
Fine. Be quiet. We're going to leave together, but only if you cooperate.
Fine. I will do that, but I am not going to leave you. I'm not running away.
Forget it.
Leave you to get...
I can't.
Jason. Fine, what is the plan?
The plan is to do what I tell you, when I tell you.
Fine, but you promise me that you will stay alive.
Alcázar está vivo. Su avión cayó en la isla cerca de Tortola.
Usted fue muy inteligente al no hacer ningún trato con los prisioneros.
Alcázar se lo va a agradecer.
Ya veremos. The good news is your boss is alive. The bad news is... not for long. Let's go.
Where?
You can die here now, or you can enjoy 15 more minutes of life.
My husband is gonna rip your throats out.
Sonny Carinthos, remember his name, because he's gonna kill you.
Carinthos.
How long did these people show up?
Not long. My men have the exact coordinates. They should have no trouble locating us. Well, aren't you going to thank me for saving our lives? It wasn't easy putting this jet down safely.
Yeah, you're a hell of a pilot.
There was a minute or two while I wasn't sure, but... how could I let you die?
Now you think I'm going to thank you?
I might enjoy that. You want to blame me for everything that's happened, Brenda, but we're both better. All I've ever done is try to keep my promise to you.
Okay, you need to go take a walk for a second. Okay?
No, go take a... what do you mean go take a walk?
That's simple. He wants to execute me and he doesn't want you to see it. What, are you afraid you'll disgust her? That she'll see you for who you really are? Common thief. Shoot a man without a gun. Because he's betting that if I'm dead by the time my men get here, I'll be able to buy them off. He assumes they're like him. For sale to the highest bidder. Sonny's not special, Brenda. He's common. A common criminal.
You're trying to get him to kill you, Luis. Is that
I'm simply
want?
Stating a fact.
He's working you, Brenda. He's trying to buy time. He's hoping that you still love him. Enough, ain't that right? You're thinking that if she hates you, that's better than nothing, right? At least she still cares. Maybe she cares enough if you die, and you're hoping, Luis, that that's gonna stop me. But it wouldn't stop you, Luis, would it? Would it? Brenda, come here. I gotta talk to you about something.
Listen, I don't want you to hurt him.
What are you doing?
Levántate!
What?
¡Que te bajes!
You'd be one hell of a ball player, Carly.
Get up!
Your special bat under the bench, hit the ball out of the park.
Vamos, bájate! Hacer tus últimas plegarias,
hey,
adiós.
Okay.
Okay. Oh my God.
All right, come on. Wait. Come here.
Get these keys.
Where?
Get these keys.
Get.
Here.
All right.
Get that guy's gun over there. Get that guy's gun.
Right now, this very moment, this is what you've always feared, Brenda. You begged me to stop this from happening, to protect you from yourself. This isn't you, Brenda. This angry woman standing over me, threatening me with a gun. This is the disease. It's keeping you from remembering the life we've shared. Your faith in me. Faith so strong you trusted me to take care of you for 4 years. Promise me you'll tell me when it's time. How many times did you say that? Because you knew at some point you're going to become like your mother, Brenda.
Shut up.
It's time, Brenda. The disease is in charge.
He's working you. He's working you.
No, he's right. You're right. I am crazy. Someday, I won't know you. I won't remember you. Sissy, I won't feel bad for killing you. No.
Don't listen to him, Brendan.
I saved your life.
He's working you.
I literally pulled you from the ocean.
Give me the gun. Give me the gun.
It's not human nature to kill the man who saved your life, Brenda. You can't kill me, and you can't let Corinthos do it if you prove your mother right. You will be her, Brenda. You're crazy enough to kill me and somehow justified in doing it.
He's just stalling, okay? He was waiting for his people to get here. Give me the gun.
It's murder, Brenda. Toss the gun into the jungle.
Just go ahead. Give me the gun.
Yeah.
Give me the gun. Give me the gun.
Toss the gun, Brenda. Toss it.
Tortola in about 10 minutes.
The guy said Sonny was near Tortola, not on Tortola.
We need to get a boat to search the surrounding islands.
How many islands?
Carly, we're gonna find him, okay?
Yeah, and you know, tell me, what if Alcazar's men find him first, huh? You know what? Brenda is not in danger. Alcazar will take her. He will take her away.
Don't,
they will disappear. And you know what?
This.
What would happen? You know what's gonna happen? You know Sonny's gonna end up dead.
Don't do this, Carly.
What? You know what? You think she's gonna be happy then? You think that if Sonny dies, it'll be enough for
Sonny
Brenda?
Sonny is not going to die.
No, you know what? He can't. Because I can't lose him. Was right. I'm gonna hurt someone again.
No, you're not. You're not gonna hurt
anybody.
Yeah,
I will.
No, you're not. Set you free.
Woo!
How you feeling?
Okay.
Feel good? Uh-huh.
Why has it taken so long to land this thing?
Because the tower has to clear us, and that takes time.
Jason, this is an emergency.
Carly, You need to relax. There's nothing you can do right now.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I'll relax. No problem. Sure, you know, my husband just happens to be marooned on an island with a man who wants to kill him and a woman who wants to sleep with him. But, you know what? No problem. I'll relax. You know what? You know this is true.
Are you going to keep this up? Are you going to keep doing this?
Fighting for my husband? Yeah. You better believe it. Back as soon as we can.
Hey. I'd like to rent the boat that's tied up to the dock outside. I'm willing to pay a lot of money.
You could have to ask the owner over there, the man who's dealing.
That guy, right there?
His name is Creed. Good luck.
I understand you own that boat that's tied up in the front.
Ah, she's a beauty, isn't she? Named her Esmeralda after my fourth wife. I restored every inch of her myself, from stem to stern.
Work.
She's the best thing in these waters.
You know what? I'd like to rent it for a few days.
Esmeralda's not for rent.
I'll really make it worth your while.
You could offer me $1 million. My answer's still the same.
You like to gamble?
Gambling and drinking are my two demons of choice.
How about a wager?
What's that?
Cut the cards to the boat. High card wins.
You're kidding me.
No, $10,000 against a boat rental. Take it or leave it.
I'll take the bet, but not the game. Match me. Shot for shot. If I pass out, you get Esmeralda.
Line them up.
Not yet. This one condition.
What's that?
You don't do the drinking. She does.
You all right?
Yeah. He's gone. It's my fault.
Forget about it. It's okay.
At least he's not armed, right?
Just one of these people are gonna get here first, probably. Just waiting for you. Gonna take you with him, try to get rid of me. Big enough to be seen from the water in the air.
Help's gonna come.
Let's just hope Alcazar doesn't get here first. You want to drink against the lady?
That's right.
That's not much of a gamble. Look, I'll double my offer, $20,000 for your boat.
I drink against her on no boat.
Come on, man. You're five times, six
times. Okay, you know, we'll take the
well. Yeah. Okay, hold. What? Excuse me for a minute, please. Are you out of your mind?
No, because I can do this.
Call me.
Jason, just put up the money.
All right, you got yourself a bet.
Get the keys to my boat. A shot of rum for me, and what is your name, honey?
Carly.
A shot for Carly, my friend.
Cheers.
Made right down the street.
Yeah. Out of what? Rubbing alcohol and goat dung?
Could be. Old man Sweeney don't give out his secret recipe.
Keep it coming.
Huh. I like your style.
From around here?
Florida, actually.
Yeah? I grew up there.
Ah, yeah. The blonde cheerleader type, huh?
Well, you know, I have to admit I was a cheerleader, but it certainly doesn't mean I'm a pushover. My best friend and I, oh my God, we used to pull the craziest stunts and we would never, ever get caught. I swear. There was this one time, though. We set fire to our country club, not ours, of course, but the country club's fence. Let me tell you, we got nailed, right? It was no big deal. I am telling you, it was one post. But of course, they had to make a big deal because, heaven forbid, there is a chink in the wall between the snobs and the unwashed, right? So then I got older. I moved up north to where my biological mother lives, and you know what, it's too long of a story because, you're gonna be passed out cold on the floor by the time I get to the part where I shot her husband.
No stealing, Esmeralda. You got to win this fair and square.
You think I could get some to take on back home?
Anything for you, little lady.
Oh, excuse me.
Oh, no help. No helping out.
Okay.
No.
Doug.
She's on her own. Where you going?
I'm just going to stretch my legs. Stretchier than I. Thank you. Oh. So, you want to know something?
Yeah.
I really want your boat.
Why are you so desperate for my
book? You want to know? You really want to know? I'm going to tell you why.
Okay.
because my husband... Oh, cheers. Oh. He was on one of those desert islands out there. And he is with this nasty, nasty little viper, okay, from his past. And she is slithered her way back into his life, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna tell you something right now, okay? Because she's playing this desert island thing for all it's worth, because I know her. I can see her now, you know, she's probably doing a little island dance, and she's playing this for all it's worth. She is... You know what she's doing? She's trying to seduce my husband, and I'm going to tell you, Creed, what I'm going to do when I get to her. By this big brown mess of hair she has, I'm gonna yank her back, I'm gonna knock her down. I'm gonna feed her to the sharks.
Yeah?
You then wanna know what I'm gonna do then? I'm gonna sit around and listen to her scream.
That'll teach her a lesson.
We did it.
Okay, let's get the key.
Oh, gosh.
Louise blew that up at the flare gun. You think you got that idea from me?
What the hell were you thinking?
I was thinking that, you know, they'd let me out if I blew the ship up. It seemed like a good idea at the time.
Really?
Yeah, worked, didn't it?
You never stopped surprising me.
Not good or bad?
A little both.
You know, I wish you'd surprise me a little more. I always know what you're gonna do.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. What the...
Just stay right here. I'll be right back.
No,
just wait.
Drop the gun. Drop the gun or she's dead.
I drank way too much. Everything's rocking.
Because well, you're on a boat.
Oh, that's right. We're gonna save Sonny.
Sit down.
You know, he's gonna be mad. He's gonna be mad at us.
Probably.
Mr. Macho Sonny Corinthos. You know what? Forget him. I'm helping you.
Look,
I'm helping.
No,
I'm getting my sea legs on.
Down.
What?
Okay, give me your arm.
You know what? You are hot. You are, and you are so much nicer than Sonny. And you're more patient, and you know what? You're really good in bed.
You are. No. I need to put this on.
You remember the first time that we made love? Each other's names.
Carly, let it go. I need to put this on. You need this on.
You know what? First time I saw you, without your shirt on, I thought I was going to pass out because you're hot.
Stop it.
You look so good.
Listen to me.
This is not
keep that on.
Fashionable.
Don't. Stop it. Drink this, okay?
What?
Hey.
What?
You need to be sober when we find your husband.
Is that rum? That was good stuff.
Sit down.
You know what? You want to know something? None of your other little gritty, goody, girly friends would have been able to drink that guy at a table, Brenda.
Hold on.
Give me a break.
Hold on.
You know what? I would like a little credit, is what I'd like.
Well, you can get credit, okay? Drink that coffee.
They deserve it.
Drink the coffee.
Then will I get credit?
Yeah, you'll get credit.
Fine. Don't you remind me of? You remind me of one of those Roman statues, you know? I mean, not the ones with the togas. Well, maybe you do. I've never seen you in a toga. Can you? I have not. You remind me of one of those naked ones.
Carly.
They're bulging.
Carly, stop it!
Rippling. What? Can you just not admit that sex with me was the best?
Can you just shut up and drink your coffee, okay?
Hey, just joking, playing with you a little bit. Sure.
Hey, look at that.
What?
Looks like a fire on that island. It could be them.
Hey. You've gone through a lot of trouble to come after Brenda. You're not going to hurt her.
Try me.
You know why? Because she means everything to you, Luis.
I've reevaluated the relationship since you tried to kill me. Drop the gun!
No.
Now!
Let her go!
I'm not dropping.
Drop the gun, man!
Good.
Whoa!
Get out of here, Brenda! Go! Move!
Wait, somebody!
Stay tuned for scenes from the next General Hospital.
What am I supposed to do now? Beg you for my life?
Wouldn't do any good.
Well, that's not gonna happen. Go ahead, Luis. Shoot me. See how many brownie points you get. For Brenda, because that's what you're after, isn't it? Huh? You get rid of me and Jax. Brenda walks over the dead bodies, she comes back to you.
Mostly, I'm looking for the satisfaction of killing you. I've wanted to handle this job personally from the beginning. Now you don't have your backup. You don't have Roy, or Brenda, or your bulletproof vest. It's just you and me.
And me. Kill us at the same time.
Guarantee one of us is gonna get you.
Why don't we test that theory?
Okay, please. Tell me that's not quicksand.
I wish I could. I'm really not sure.
I have to
listen
to you.
No. Forget about me. Sonny needs help. Go find Sonny.
Well, you know what? Jason's with him, and you know what? You know what?
You look like you need
help.
Stop dying anyway. Who cares about me? Go find Sonny.
Oh, my God. Do you ever get tired of pretending to be noble? Huh? You know, I mean, I'm not dense, okay? I've been with Sonny long enough. Why don't you stop moving? You're going to go further in there.
I'm trying to get out. I'm trying to get out.
Oh, yeah. Luminous Brenda goes. She's back.
Listen, maybe you should stop talking and help somebody.
Did you just tell me to be responsible? Listen, quick, Sam.
Oh,
you are.
God.
You know what?
You
don't bark
unpleasant.
Orders at me.
Just always.
Oh, yeah, well, you know what? I'm all you got. So, deal with it.
All right, that branch is not big enough. It's not going to hold
grab
me.
On,
no, I can't
on.
Even reach the damn branch.
Just try it, okay?
I can't reach it.
Try!
I am trying! Poor little Brenda! You know, you are such a whiner. Anyone ever tell you that? You can't get out of it. Tied to the railroad track.
All right, just hold the damn branch over
come
here.
And save me. Come on, grab, grab.
I am being still.
Okay, all right. You see?
Hey!
Okay, you feel better? You see this root over there? You think maybe you could grab it?
Does it look like I can grab it? No. If I could grab that, do you think I would still be in here
well,
with you?
Well, you know, Brenda, I'm not so sure. You want to know why? Because you let things happen
yeah,
to you.
Yeah, great. A new line scheme all day. That's much better. You should have listened before when I told you to be careful.
No, you're
still
you know
out
what?
There.
I should have listened when you told me not to help you in the first
yeah.
place.
Why did you help me?
You know what? Because no one would have believed that I didn't leave you here on purpose.
You know, what is your problem? Why couldn't you have just disappeared? Why did... Oh, why am I...
Why do you have to make Sonny drag you around?
Oh,
after,
honey,
what
no one dragged Sonny anywhere. He came out here after me because he wanted to.
Right. Right.
Okay.
Where's Sonny now? Where is he? Huh? And where is Jason? And where's... Excuse me. Where is anybody?
God, what did you just... What did you drink?
That's really bad. You know, it doesn't matter what the hell I drank.
Bad.
I will have you know.
Like such an idiot. You're a...
You know what? I'll have you know I drank
hey.
To get you out. Oh, you... Hey!
Okay, here we go.
Help
here
us.
We go. Hand, please. You want to try and...
I'll hang.
Come over here.
Oh, my God. Oh, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm
ready?
Fine.
Hold on.
Come on, Brenda, let's go!
Give me 1 second.
You need help, man? Everybody good?
I think so.
How'd you guys find it? That's a long story.
Yeah, well, you know, I just want to know something, okay? What was Alcazar holding both of you for the whole time?
Look, there's
or
a boat and a plane
what?
Landing, okay? Let's go. We got to get out
well,
of here.
Well, you know what? I've got a few minutes here, okay? It's not going to matter much, is it?
Like Jason said, it's a long story.
You know what? I'll take notes.
It was me and Brendan Alcazar, and it got rough. But you're here, and it's all good. You all right?
Yeah, I'm okay. It's... My head feels like it's on fire. I'm fine. Thanks. For everything.
Could you, define everything?
I mean, thank you for saving my life.
How does it feel to know your husband risked death for a former love?
Shut up.
I've never seen a man so committed to saving a woman's life he didn't love.
You know, Sonny and I have gotten each other out of some tight spots in our lives. It's like you and Jason. It's nothing.
Is everything all right? Everybody all right?
Yeah. It's fine.
You're supposed to be sleeping.
Yeah, well, so are you. Any other man would be wiped out after facing a life or death situation with Alcazar on that island. But then again, you're not any other man.
Don't you forget that. I'm gonna throw this stuff out. Any objections?
Oh, I kind of wanted to keep the jeans.
Did you have like 1,000 pair of these?
Yeah, I know, but those turned out to be lucky for me.
All right. How about I make you something to eat? Mm. Or those rum shots just kicked your butt last night?
Actually, I feel pretty good. So I think that island rum agreed with me.
Or the quicksand.
Hey, come here. Don't go away.
Mm-hmm.
Is what Alcazar said true? That something happened between you and Brenda on the island?
You know what? You shouldn't believe everything Alcazar says.
I'm not saying that. I'm asking you a question and you're not answering it.
Well, Alcazar would do anything to get Brenda back. He wants you suspicious. He wants me distracted. He wants Brenda isolated so that way it ups his chances of grabbing her again. Brenda and I, we went through a lot on that island. But you are my wife. And I love you. Either you trust that or you don't.
No, nowhere. I'm just getting my stuff together. Jason's taking me away, and this time it'll be for good.
So when are you leaving?
Right away. You know, Jax is healthy, and
yeah,
you seem to be doing pretty good. You even seem kind of happy. I'm glad.
What about you?
I'll be happy, knowing I'm too far away from here to hurt anybody. And knowing that I won't make any wrong decisions.
Jason will be a big help if you let him. You know, it's all right to let people help.
That sounds pretty cute coming from you. Mr. In Control, I don't need anybody.
I guess I'll miss your smile all over again.
You remember that day?
First.
I was carrying the suitcase.
You're carrying the suitcase about right over there.
Yeah.
There's snow on the ground. It's, yeah.
This is where we met. Listen, Emma. I just want you to know that, you know, I forgive you for everything. Make sure you stay happy, all right? Be blessed. You all right? Did something happen while you were out?
No, not really. I ran into Brenda and I guess her illness is getting worse. So Jason's gonna take her back to Europe.
For good?
Well, it looks that way.
Well, you must be worried.
Well, I'm not going to deny it. I just, you know, but that's not the point. She told me to be blessed. And I realized that I was. More than I expected. I've got the life that I've always wanted, the family that I value more than anything in this world. You've given me that, okay? And I love you for it.
Yeah. Mrs. Jax.
So sorry to interrupt, but I just couldn't wait to tell you the happy news. Sonny, I think, will be happy. You, not so sure about.
What's your point?
Yeah, what is your point?
All right, I'll make it short and sweet. Alcazar's been bribing Brenda's doctors. They've been lying to her. Brenda doesn't have her mother's illness.
You sure about this?
Positive. Barring the unforeseen, Brenda's going to live.
Brenda isn't dying.
She never was. Alcazar paid her doctors off to lie to her.
She had headaches, symptoms, nightmares. What are you talking
about? Brenda may well be crazy, and she certainly seems it from what I've seen of her, but it's not from any genetic brain disease, okay? Alcazar made Brenda think that she was dying so that he could control her, to have all to herself.
Why should we believe you?
Do you know how difficult this is for me?
Then why bother?
What do you want?
I'm trying to save my marriage. I just told you, Brenda isn't dying. Now, whether you like it or not, that involves the both of you.
Excuse me. Yeah?
Brenda's with Jax.
Where?
Lily's grave. No, she's okay, Sonny. She isn't sick. Alcazar paid her doctors to lie.
Yeah, I know. We need to go over this, what happened in Miami, now.
All right, I'll meet you at the Elm Street Pier.
I'll be there.
Hey, where are you going?
It's just business.
Is Jason okay?
Yeah, it's no problem. Brenda's, you know, not gonna die either. She's actually with Jax. I'll be back in no time, okay?
Mm. So this is why you're here again. You want Sonny to take Brenda away from Jax.
So, tell me, how did Brenda and Jax end up at Lily's grave?
All right. Brenda got a headache this morning. This one was the worst I've seen. It was bad, okay? She was in so much pain she could barely move. So I got Alan to examine her, and he said that the pain was from hitting her head, and you guys had the emergency landing, and maybe a little dehydration.
Okay, I don't understand what this has to do with Brenda at Lily's grave.
Okay. Brenda thought the headache was proof that her disease was going into the terminal stage, okay? She wanted to get to Europe. She wanted to leave to Europe immediately, and I believed her.
Yeah, I know. She told me goodbye.
I don't think she wanted to go to Europe. I mean, I went out. I made the arrangements to go. I came back. She was gone. My gun was... She stole my gun.
She took your gun because she wanted to end it.
Or she wanted to go after Alcazar. When she had that nervous breakdown, she went to Lily's grave, right?
Yeah, she told me about it.
Well, I guess Jax must have figured something out. I don't know how, because when I went to check on her, he was there. They were talking, laughing. She knows she's not gonna die.
How did Brenda seem to you?
What'd she seem? Like, happy, I guess. I mean, you know, this morning she was talking about the disease and how afraid she was. Now it's not gonna happen.
How about the 4 years Alcazar took from her? I mean, all he, you know, he put fear in her.
Yeah.
I wonder what her life would have been if, you know, she'd known all along.
How it happened, so why even bother thinking about that? Just...
You're right. I was going to ask you about Brenda in front of Carly, but I didn't want her to flip into next week. It's kind of hard on her.
Right.
And I'm not being fair. You know what? There's something I got to do. We'll talk more about it later.
Do you know how pathetic you are? Trying to shove Brenda off on Sonny?
Ooh.
Sounds like I hit a nerve.
Well, you and Jax obviously didn't even make it 3 months, and you're hurting. So believe it or not, I feel sorry for you.
Yeah, well, you know what, Carly? Save the sympathy for yourself, because I think that Brenda's going to go back to Sonny, not Jax.
Oh, really? Okay, who's with her right now, and who was it who had to run off and tell her the good news?
Look, Jax can't go back to Brenda, or his life will mean nothing.
Oh, well, tell Jax that. I mean, if you can drag him out of bed with Brenda. Because I'm assuming that's where they are right now, making up for lost time.
Hey, Lily. How you doing? I didn't bring any flowers. I know I haven't brought them in a while. But that doesn't mean I'm not thinking about you. I remember everything, you know. I remember that I destroyed you. Our child. And it was because of Brenda. I'm not gonna let that happen again.
You're back.
Yeah. You're gonna go look for me?
I'm Brenda, actually. Because I figured you'd be with her.
I wasn't.
Why couldn't you find her?
I wanted to be home with my wife.
Glad that you're back. But I just need to know why.
Jason told me that Brenda went to Lily's grave. She was there with Jax, and I guess Jason just went there to tell her that she didn't have the disease.
So you went to Lily's grave?
Yeah.
Did you see Brenda?
No, she was gone. But I knew where to look for her, but I didn't go.
Why not?
Because I needed time to, you know, stop and think. So I stood there alone, you know, in the dark, and I remembered what my life used to be. Silent, alone. Full of memories. How I accepted that life because I thought I deserved it. Then you crashed into my life. You made this penthouse into a home. Toys on the floor, you know. Lingerie on the tower. Lights, noise, all.
Was it just the best you could do without Brenda?
I want to be with my wife. I want to be home. I want to be with you.
Why? Why? Is it because it's familiar? Or do you want me more than you want Brenda?
I don't want Brenda.
Then why did you rush out of here the minute that you heard she wasn't dying?
I needed to talk to Jason.
About business. Why couldn't you just tell me that you wanted to see Brenda and find out about her?
In front of Sky?
That's my point. Okay, you couldn't even wait before she left to get out of here.
I needed to know the truth. I didn't want to fight with you, you know? I mean, it's obvious how you feel about Brenda, and I'm not blaming you.
Okay, listen. I'm glad she's gonna live, okay? I mean, I don't like her, but I never wanted her to die. Listen to me, okay? I'm just trying to figure out
and understand how you feel about her.
Why are you pushing so hard?
Because you're not giving me a straight answer.
Brenda was my girlfriend. She was. I mean, she in the past. You're my wife.
And so was Lily.
Yeah.
And she was sweet, and she loved you. But Brenda set your heart on fire. Does she still? Do I set your heart on fire?
You always say. I'll get rid of whoever.